Hi, I'm Cameron McKenzie at CameronMCNZ on Twitter, and I wanted to show you how to do a little Struts 2 example, Struts 2.5 in fact, and do it inside of Eclipse. So as you can see, this Struts 2.5 and Eclipse example is working with the 2020.06 version of Eclipse, which I think is pretty up to date. First thing I'm going to do as I kick off this project is I'm going to create a basic Maven project. So I'm going to go in here, look for Maven, create a basic Maven project. It's just going to be a simple project. I'm going to fill in all of the particulars of the Maven file by hand. The group ID will be com.mcnz. The artifact ID, just struts example. And of course, we're going to be using a war file right here. I'm going to click finish. It's going to bark back at me just a little bit because it's going to say, hey, you know, if you've got a war file, you should have a web.xml file as well. You can kind of see that in the error there. Not to worry, we're going to add that web.xml file in shortly. But first, I want to just deal with some of the dependencies that we have in this Struts 2.5 application in Eclipse. You'll notice that we have to add the dependency for the Struts core. We want to add the dependency for the struts convention, which will give us access to annotations and all sorts of other great things. And of course, we're going to leverage the servlet and JSP API. It's a Java web application. Why wouldn't you? So those three dependencies need to be added. And also, I've got JDK 1.8 on this machine here. And so just to enforce JDK 1.8 compliance, I'm going to add this build plugin here, which says, you know, we're going to compile the source and generate target code based on JDK 1.8. Now, feel free to slap my wrist for not using JDK 11, which is currently the latest long-term support release. But this should be good for this example. Oh, I don't like the way that that formatted that there, but you know, I'm not going to get too worried about it. What I am worried about is this little error that says there's no XML file, and that's easily remedied. All I have to do is go into this main web app folder, create a new folder called webinf, pronounced with all uppercase letters, and in there generate a new file just called web.xml, and that'll make one of the errors go away at the very least, you know, that we don't have that, hey, no XML, web.xml found. But that's not exactly a well-formed web.xml file in itself, so I need to update that. And I'm just going to paste in a web.xml file here. You can see it's got the regular overly verbose preamble right there. It's got the name, you know, struts in Eclipse without the config file. But this is interesting. So all of the stuff above is just standard, but you'll notice that I've got a filter mapping here for struts, and specifically the struts prepare and execute filter. This is going to capture every request that comes into this web module and force it to go through the standard struts flow of input, actions, output, success, all of those other interesting things that Struts does. So this is really what's needed to make Struts a part of your web application. Now, one thing to mention, if you're using prior to Struts 2.5, I believe the package name is a little different. And if you are using Struts 0.5 and you don't have that exact package name, you might get a can't find this file or something like that. So just be careful, make sure you're using Struts 2.5. If you do get that error message, it's probably just the package that you're referencing might not be correct. You may have copy and pasted from a different tutorial that's a little older than this one. Shame on you. Okay, so that is now the web.xml file configured and really the heart of Struts configured here as well. Now I want to write a little application that someone's going to type their name into, and then we're going to say, hey, welcome Cameron or welcome Joe. That's going to require, well, I guess that's going to require a JSP file or an HTML file. Why don't I create a new, well, why don't I just create a basic HTML file? Keep things simple. I'll call it index.html. This will create a basic one for me. And as I said, I'm going to create this really, really simple. I'm going to replace that with just really just an HTML page that has nothing more than this form in it. And this form just says, may I ask your name? It's got an input text file where someone will type their name, a submit button where they click submit. And when they click submit, it's going to call on the struts action associated with the term hello. You'll also notice that the input here is put into a text field called first name. And so I want that first name to get set on a property of an action being over on the server. So that's another important property that I need to think about as well. But this will be the input page, and this will call on our struts action class. Now that does mean that I have to create a new struts action class. I'll put in the package com.mcnz.struts, and I'll call it the hello action, because this is kind of a hello world type of application that I'm creating right here. Right off the bat, there we go, we've got the hello action. I did mention that there's going to be a property named first name that's going to be a field that's being submitted to the server. So you want to create a variable that maps to that property. And it also makes sense to create the associated setters and getters for that property as well. Now, the thing about a struts action class is it should have a method called execute. And in this execute method, you're supposed to perform a bunch of logic. And if the logic is successful, you're supposed to return a text string that says success. And that success string is then mapped to some file some JSP file or resource that will render a result for the client. Also inside this method, you can gain access to any of these properties. So I think I might even say, I'm gonna do a little system.out.print here that says, hey, you know, the value of first name that was passed in is equal to first name. Now this is going to represent the processing. I mean, you might save something to a database, you might send an email, you might persist something, perform logic. We're going to keep it simple here. We're just going to return success. But what happens when we return success from this execute method? Well, normally things like action mappings and where we go if there's a success or a failure, that would get mapped in a struts.xml file. But we don't have to do that anymore when we're using annotations. Instead, you can just put this tag above the hello action class that says, you know, when this runs, if we have a successful result, so that is the return of this method is the word success, then we'll send somebody to the results JSP. And then you could have, you know, something that says if it's equal to failure, send them to the error page. So that's how this result tag works. Also, this hello action, notice it gets mapped to this hello.action here. How does the framework know that when someone asks for the hello action, that it should be this hello action that gets called? It's not as simple as the fact that it's called hello action. You're supposed to actually have an action mapping. Again, this is something that would normally go inside of a struts config file. With annotations, you can just put it right onto your action class. Now, I am getting barked out a little bit here. Can't resolve those things, so I've got to organize my imports. When I do that, you see that it imports the action and result. And then if I do a control S and save, all of the errors go away. So this is really what your struts action class looks like. It's a fairly simple action class. I'll organize some of the code structure there. But you can see it's got a property that maps to all of the properties in your form that's being submitted, and then an execute method to implement some logic, and all of the requisite action and results mapping. Now, I do say that if this runs successfully, which it always will, I can't see this throwing an exception, we should call on the result.jsp page. And I'd like to say, you know, hey, welcome, whatever the person's first name is on that page. So over here in the web app, I create I'll call it result.jsp. So this creates the basic JSP file. Now I call this results. Notice that in the, I went to look for the struts config file there. Notice here that the annotation is result singular. The file I'm going to is result plural with an S on it. I just want a little distinction there to show you that, you know, it's not this name that's being used, it's this name here. So I've got the results.jsp file, and I don't really want to do anything too crazy in it. Right at the beginning, I need to add a couple of these tags here. This is just your page directive that says this is really a JSP page that's going to generate HTML. There's also this taglib directive that I need, and this is part of the struts taglib, but it's going to be used to help print out this property to the user. So I want to gain access to this property that's inside this action class. That action class is passed into this JSP so I can access some of its data. Now it should be a well-formed HTML page. And so that means starting off with your HTML and body tags and then finishing with your end body and end HTML tag. I'm also just going to add a little text here in the body that says, hey, this is the results page. That's just so that when the page comes up, we know where we are. And then I'm going to add this. Remember, we've asked somebody to type in their name. I'm going to say, hey, hello, whatever your first name is. That's the first name that was entered into this text field here. It's the first name that was assigned to this property here. And it's getting displayed using this struts tag associated with the prefix S that will display a property that it can find in the current scope, and specifically the property of first name. Now I am getting this little warning right here. It says, hey, you know, we're having a problem with this S property thing. I think it's just because I've got these reverse, one of your taglib first up there. Click Control S and that goes away. Now for the most part, I think I'm done this application. I can right click on this and say run as, run on server. I do have a Tomcat server already configured here. So you can see Tomcat 9. I'll click finish. Restart the server. I guess it was already started up. It'll only take a second. This should bring up my HTML page that maps to the index.html right here. You can see, may I ask your name? Input was the first name, and then it's got the submit button. And then I'm going to say, yeah, my name's Cameron. I'll click submit. It'll call on the action. You can see that the action says, hey, the value of first name is Cameron. That was printed out from the action right here. And then finally, when it gets to the results page, which is this JSP right here, hey, it's going to print out our first name from that's held inside that action. It then says, this is the results page and hello, Cameron. And there you go. That's how you create a very basic Struts 2.5 web application without a struts config file in Eclipse. And there you go, that's how easy it is to do a nice little round trip with Struts 2.5 inside of the Eclipse IDE. Now, if you enjoyed this tutorial, why don't you head over to theserverside.com? We've got lots of great tutorials on all sorts of enterprise Java frameworks, DevOps, anything that has to do with enterprise software development in general. If you're interested in my personal antics, you can follow me on Twitter at CameronMCNZ and subscribe on YouTube.